That's all that you can really say. Disappointment.
I mean, so they do have decent siege with this composition. You know, you can utilize the culling and the rockets coming out from Corki to really get people off a turret and take that one down. And as we hop into Summoner's Rift for game number one, we'll see what the sword is. This might be part of the strategy the Griffin has. The Umbral Dash going to be utilized there. Noggery still has his flash available, but he's not actually going to utilize it.
Atlas.
Yeah, Tarzan's going to find one here as Showmaker is going to go down pretty comfortably. Canyon as well, and so having infinite mana on a team like this is certainly not what you want. Okay, the turret is going to stay up for now.
And this is going to cause them to stay, so a bit of a blunder right there, but they're going to end up getting it anyway in the end.
Yep, Tarzan comes on over. There's the final chapter. It's a great relentless pursuit, gets them out of the way. They do clear another minion wave, so they bought a little bit of time with this one as the culling. Going to get eaten by Iroh, throws back his four people. Should be enough to take down both of these. Nuclear is going to be the first one to go down, and Hoyt absolutely nowhere to go. They've over-indexed on the kills, as we might even have another one as Canyon goes golden. They just can't get enough damage into Sword here as Noggery finally gets away from this minion wave, and the World Ender was not enough to get the damage done as he just teleports out. Sword is very
hop into a helicopter, put on some goggles, and...
Well, Hoyt, he's had this problem before. That's five people as the package was available, and Showmaker just sidesteps the hook. Canyon considering diving on in, as that's the big one onto Iroh. That is not what you want to see as Canyon dives on over. Yukal looking to potentially turn. Valkyrie, remember, still available here for Showmaker as Prowling Projectile comes in. Viper
Tarzan's
over the wall, does have bullet time available, and Tarzan gets in there. It's a 50-50, and there's the Ocean Soul. Canyon dives in, Tarzan goes golden. There's the two-man Shurima shuffle from Yukal, and this just might be it. It's a double kill for the MF. The cat has found Nuclear, who relentlessly pursues.
So, right now they're just taking this very slow and steady. They have the Shurima turret behind them. And Damwon, they can't take.
Oh god, Viper explodes. There's the Shurima shuffle to get Canyon out, but that's what he wanted to do anyway. The MF just dies for free. Viper not entirely sure as Arctic Assault is utilized, but has to throw out the ultimate in order to escape, and I don't know whether it's going to be enough. As Zoomies come in, another Prowling Projectile down as well. Noggery unable
to. Now.
Yep, coins in the air, everyone. Down to about half health is the Elder Drake, as there's the Redemption, getting all the health back here for Griffin. Noggery thinking about when his time to engage is going to be. Remember, Yukal, if they're all stacked up like this, it's going to be his time to shine. This is real dicey.
They're all stacked up, and if everyone just goes in, they can't just stand their ground.
Well, that's exactly what Tarzan saw as well. Canyon's going to dive in. Shurima Shuffle going to be used just to get rid of the Canyon. Showmaker is going to get out, but he's only limping. And Griffin, make the intelligent choice. They're just going to take the Elder Drake because it's given to them on a silver platter.
So that's what I run in at them with the
stage of the game. Yukal going to pop over the wall. And now the siege is on. First Nexus turret should be taken down here as the culling just eaten by Tarzan for breakfast. He loved it. An enjoyable one there. A sword is going to get kited here by Showmaker. A fair bit of damage going to come down as MF is going to take out the Jarvan first. Not a lot of damage there from the Emperor's Divide, but it looks like Griffin just have enough money in their back pockets in order to win this one, as Hoyt says, nah, sorry, Noggery. I am getting off this wild ride. Take me back. Take me back to the beginning of this game. As Griffin will be able to take down this Nexus. Sword goes golden on the fountain, almost gets Tarzan killed, and eventually, oh no! Saved from defeat there.
That wouldn't have changed the game dramatically.
Wow.
They're solo laners, Corki and obviously Noggery, Showmaker and Noggery. They did win in CS. Corki even had the call to boot, and that was after him getting killed twice.
One Sejuani adding now, a little bit there as well, so an opportunity.
The broadcast that typically you can try to fight Soraka with long-range mages, and Victor is one of those champions. Syndra, another one.
Going to be okay. Tarzan looking for a gank bottom side though, as Viper taking a lot of damage. It's a great bait from Griffin here, as Nuclear has to flash to get out of the way. Battle Dance, I believe, is on cooldown as the Dark Binding lands. The Nuclear trying to offer enough damage back to keep Hoyt alive. Heal does turn up. Now Viper looking for it, but Canyon's going to be here as well. Iroh, a very early flash there, and then Viper going to have to use his as well. Not enough black shields, but also not enough distance on that grand entrance.
You got to get into this brush here as the
Dragon is low, but Yukao just straight up misses the supreme display of talent. The Ornhorn is going to land. The Qiyana just falls flat on her face. Not sure what that was. More about what she offers in a team fight as the game continues. Grand entrance comes in, but the grand exit is towards the death chamber.
Well,
it's very, very confusing. As Tarzan has been caught out of position. Iroh trying to get on over here, but the Ornhorn has been called. The knock-up, Showmaker makes him brittle, smacks him in half.
I would say that's a possibility.
We're going for a deep flank here. As Tarzan is behind enemy lines, Great Ward there is going to spot it out, plus Hoyt's here. He's trying to stop Tarzan from getting on in. This Nexus turret's going to go down. Good Knight Sword, but he's going to go golden. For the moment, Ornhorn comes in, Wish comes out. Sword survives for a lot longer than you otherwise would expect, but Damwon just take down the Unicorn in the end. Yukao finally gets in there as Tarzan does take down Canyon, but that Chaos Storm did one hell of a lot of damage, and now Hoyt looking to tie everyone up. Yukao, I think, pressed a couple of buttons, but it wasn't really enough as a double kill comes in for the Zaya, and we are going to go to a game three. I think this game started at around 27 minutes. And Griffin, they picked the Soraka, they passed that test. But otherwise, not really too many tests being passed here today. 11,000 gold, the ending lead as Damwon do pick up 6 kills to the 2 offered up by Griffin.
Before you can learn to pull yourself out of it. You know?
How big is the hole when you lose with Soraka?
I don't know. But I don't know whether he's going to be able to leap over that gap without a rope, if you know what I'm saying. You know?
In the later stages, and then be able to win out, but I expect that this game will have a lot.
Potentially or continue pushing things out. So I like what Damwon's comp is able to do as the game moves forward. A bit mono-red on the side of Griffin.
This is really good right now. Yukao,
Canyon
he
knows
has
exactly
the priority.
What's going on.
Yeah.
Showmaker's picked up an exhaust. Now Canyon's going to move on over. They do have vision, but it is going to be taken there by Tarzan. But now the fight is on. Nuclear moving on down here. The cat on a book is just running around, trying to get in position as Sword gets into position himself, but he's ignoring the MF, and the first blood goes to the Camille very, very quickly. Nuclear without a flash, but has used the barrier, and the heal was available there from the Yumi, and the Aatrox did basically nothing in that fight. Now Showmaker is just looking for Yukao, another auto, but a bubble will do it as well. And Damwon, they grab 4 kills.
You can see Nuclear and Hoyt just backing up. They know that Galio is moving down into the right-hand side jungle. Nuggery has...
Yeah, Hextech Ultimatum comes in. He's got a level advantage. Not going to find it. Ellie theoretically in the last one as the bubble once again going to land. This is, lighting some different kind of fires. Sparkles being added here. As Yukao...
Oh!
Oh my god, if that bubble had landed, or if Showmaker had Ignite.
Pretty phenomenal job. Griffin did get the Mountain Dragon, but... Oh man, this could be another very ugly
fight.
There's
the final chapter. The snare is going to land onto Yukao. He flashes in a very odd direction. Not sure what that one's about, but does avoid death just barely. But Hextech Ultimatum is going to kill him as an afterthought. And now Viper has to utilize the ultimate in order to get out of there. Tarzan takes a gigantic chunk from the Paddle Star.
And now Canyon and Nuggery looking like they're going to end up diving onto Sword. Tarzan's here a little late.
Sword is actually going to get out here, but Canyon has to flash Nuggery as well. He's looking for a double. Hextech Ultimatum comes in, and they've just outplayed it. Canyon, without the Arctic Assault, now trying to get out. And remember, there's no flash here. Cataclysm's done, but great first knock up there from Sword. Canyon, Arctic Assault finally comes on in, but... Sword wants to try and get some sort of engage, but the Hextech sweep working out very well there, and Nogri's just avoiding everything. Tarzan's going to move on back in, though. Hextech Ultimatum now back off cooldown. Nogri just going to burn down. Sword is very much dead underneath this turret. World Ender utilized. I wouldn't press any buttons, to be honest. Sword, you don't want to put anything on cooldown when you are definitely going to be going down.
And even though there's a Galio on the enemy team and he's able... to heroic entrance, it doesn't really matter. Viper gonna try something here.
Yeah, big flash forward from Viper. Gets into the brush. Nuclear, absolutely nothing he can do. Games. That's a little bit ironic at this point in time, especially now that Nuclear is being put out of position. Pretty cookie cutter there with the heroic entrance, but it works. Tried and tested is now Canyon. Not too many options. He was waiting, was it? For an opportunity. Zyro gonna get chunked underneath this turret. Damwon certainly with this opportunity, with this composition. Minion wave dealt with.
Whoa! Just continue to keep getting leads as they're coming for Nuggery.
Get to the Baron or to an inhibitor turret, I guess, is going to be the answer here. Okay. Iroh really wanted to chase after this kill. That was in their clutches.
Well,
bubble lands as Tarzan trying to force this, but it might be too aggressive. The flash comes in immediately. Showmaker's going to cleanse it. Final chapter doesn't go in the right direction, and the exhaust is almost unnecessary on the sword because he dies so fast. Tarzan now in the middle of three members and will just be destroyed. Viper takes one with him, but eventually goes down as well. And could this just be the end of the game as it stands? 3 minute play that Damwon were able to come out on the top of. They do close this one out in the end. 12-5, I was expecting, honestly, a 2-0 from Damwon, but they are the victors. They are going to be able to walk away with this one.
And
they're right.
They really messed up, Among Us. Yeah.
Well, I mean, maybe they were talking about game one. Because that was true. What a damage out from Noggery. 16.6k, 15.7 there for the Zoe in the mid lane as well. And